Hi, good evening. My name is Deepak Jain. We are going to continue with the technology session and various topics are there. Before that, I would like to each panelist to introduce yourself and starting from my right and in that line only, I will introduce myself.
Hi everybody, my name is Amish Gosar from PV Power, Mumbai.
Hi, I'm Idrish Khan from Jinglong Solace. Basically, I am representing string inverter, the company manufacturing it. So any technical question, discussion can be addressed to me for a little inverters, I can get.
I think you should introduce, giving some sort of idea about your companies also and the products.
So coming back, Amish here, we are a panel manufacturing company based in Bombay, having a manufacturing line at Boisar, Mumbai. Apart from, we are a 12-year-old company in this business of solar and also doing a host of mid-sized EPC projects.
Hi, this is Rohit Pandita. So I am the regional head for sales and marketing from Adani Solar. So I'm basically it's a module entity of the Adani. So we are having 1.5 gigawatt of solar manufacturing as of now, which includes our cell manufacturing. So we are, with pride, we can say we're the largest cell manufacturers of India right now. And recently we have won a tender of 2 gigawatts of module linked manufacturing tender. So it will be a 8 gigawatt of manufacturing development of projects and 2 gigawatt of manufacturing. So we'll be having the next year 3.5 gigawatt of cell and module manufacturing, and maybe by next 4-5 years we'll be having around 8 to 10 gigawatt of our development. And apart from that, we are having we're the only cell manufacturers who are having their own bifacial modules in India also. And 40% of our sales happens to US market. And currently we have done, just last month only we got 1 gigawatt of module manufacturing for this financial year. And still, we have 1 month to go for that. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Shailesh Vaidya from a company called Scorpius Trackers, which is based in Pune. We make single-axis trackers in Pune out of India. We have installed about 500 megawatts in India. This year, we have bid for about 15,000 megawatts globally, and this year, we'll do about 500 megawatts outside India as well. We have launched a very good technology with trackers for bifacial modules also installed now. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. This is Vinod Shankar. I represent Havells India Limited. So Havells Solar has been in solar business for the last 4 years now. And we have products, concurring all the value chains and modules, inverters, AC-DB, DC-DB cables, SPDs. So our motto is peace of mind, both for the consumers as well as for the system integrators, channel partners, and EPCs. Thank you.
Good afternoon, all of you. Myself, Ashok Kumar Singh, working for Novasys Green Energy Private Limited, who is a Nagpur-based company. We are into module manufacturing of 100 megawatt capacity right now, and very soon we are expanding it to 250 megawatt. Right now we are catering entire India market right now, and probably we are targeting Vietnam market as well. We have exported some parts also now, and getting good response for Novasys. Thank you.
So hi, I am Deepak Jain. I am representing Goldie Solar. We are a 500 megawatt manufacturing capacity company, and we are coming up with additional 500 megawatt. We have presence since 2011. And we are catering to Pan India, plus we are supplying modules to more than 18 countries at the moment. We are the fresh entrant in tier one list. Although my speech is same, quality comes first, and we are there as a quality supplier for your requirements. Thank you.
Good afternoon, my name is Brinder Gandhi. I am founder and CEO of Impulse Green Energy. We are distributing module, inverter, cable, connectors. In modules, we are distributing LONGi, REC, Renesola and Pennar. And in inverters, we are doing Huawei. With cables, we are doing Leoni connectors, we are doing QC. We have supplied for projects for a kilowatt also in Pune or in the Maharashtra region, and are going up to 2 or 2.5 megawatt also, which is with module, inverters, cable, connectors, all product range we have been supplying. We have warehouses in Mumbai, in Ajmer, in Chennai, and we have presence, sales presence all over India. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Prasoon Chaudhary, and I am from Pennar Group, based out of Hyderabad. So basically, we are a vertically integrated solar company. So we have an EPC portfolio of 500 megawatt. We have our own module manufacturing facility of 300 megawatts, as well as we are India's biggest module mounting structure suppliers. Till date, like, we have done more than 15 gigawatt of supplies to Indian market. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Ravi Pitti. I'm representing two companies here. One is Agni Solar. We're one of the pioneering solar companies in India, having started in 1993. And we represent all aspects of solar energy, which includes rooftop solar, off-grid, as well as solar water heating. The other is K-Pay. This is an innovative pay-as-you-go technology, which we have developed and applied for worldwide patents. This technology allows the user of any powered device to pay for the device over time as per their needs and affordability, and without requiring internet or smartphones. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much. So basically, taking ahead, you mentioned, Ravi, you mentioned about the innovation. So this particular session is focused on innovation. We have among us, I think, 5 module manufacturers. Then we have inverter company. We have structure company, obviously next generation structure company. We have distribution. So I think complete solar chain is available here. So we can discuss more on technology side, rather on finance side, because since morning we are discussing only finance, tariffs and everything. So since my entry into solar industry, I have seen the ups and downs, and during that, obviously, we are working continuously to on the verge of innovation. The solar industry is, we are continuously working on technological advancements. So I have seen we were making only 10 watt panels, then 37, 75 watt panels, then came into picture 60 cell modules. So we were using 12% efficiency cells, 11% efficiency cells. So in case of cells, now monopoke technology, the latest one, efficiency is available as high as 22%. And there are companies, they are innovating it again. So I think we worked on 5-inch cells. Currently, we are using 6-inch cells, and upcoming is M12 cells. So there are generations of cells. Currently in India, we are using M2 and M3 generation. But the latest one is M12. So we have a long way to go to use the M12 cells. Obviously, we should be equipped with such manufacturing lines if we speak about the PV modules. In case of inverters, we were using 600 volt inverters, then came into picture 1000 volt inverters. So it's the system voltage. Then we started using 1500 volt inverters. I don't know what will be the next, but yes, now it is 1500 volts, and slowly, slowly, Indian market is also adopting 1500 volt inverters. So I would like to go for first to start with the trackers, I think. Then we will go for the inverters. Then we can discuss about the PV modules. So I think Shailesh bhai,
thank you. So when we started trackers in 2014-13, this company, it was a very new technology at that time. And there was not enough data available on whether trackers, which are supposed to give about 18 to 20% more energy from the same modules, will actually do that. Now, after 5 years and 500 megawatts, we have enough data that actually that happens. But then what next for a tracker company? So as far as our technology is concerned, it is now completely wireless. It does not require cables for communication. Trackers are self-powered. etc. It's maintenance free. So one worry in the mind of new customers who have not used trackers is some moving parts. So will there need to be done some O&M or something like that? So we can say very confidently that there is zero maintenance in trackers. It's a zero maintenance technology. Having said that, from a tracker perspective, what have we done in the technology? We have got a self-powered tracker. That means we have worked a lot on our own battery management system and powering solution. So which internally a company like ours, which has worked on technology, can always scale it up to have a BMS solution for EV charging or something like that. Now trackers, currently we are doing a 30 megawatt plant in Saudi Arabia, which got us to thinking on robotic module cleaning. And in trackers, we are already controlling a two-axis motion. So why not do a robotic module cleaning solution? So there are a lot of ways which a tracker company can progress. As far as trackers itself are concerned, like I just mentioned, we have recently installed a tracker for bifacial modules. Now, last year, bifacial modules, the price difference between mono and bifacial was about 4 to 5 cents. So people were a bit slow on using bifacial modules. But next year, it is expected that bifacial module price difference with respect to mono will be less than a cent. Now, why I say this is because in the 15,000 megawatts which we have bid for globally with large IPPs, nearly 12,000 megawatts is with bifacial modules. So the whole global trend is shifting towards bifacial modules, and trackers have to be used with bifacial modules to get nearly a 26 to 35% gain from the same modules. So going ahead, technology will adapt to using bifacial modules with trackers. And as the price difference goes down to less than a cent between mono and bifacial, it will be a very exciting thing to see happen. Thanks.
So as you mentioned, globally, there is a adaptability for the technological advancements. And since you mentioned that out of 15,000 megawatts, yeah, means 15 gigawatts, you have bidded for 12 gigawatts
of
with bifacial. So what is the ratio in India?
India is hardly 5%. And people just now feel that bifacial modules are 4 to 5 cents costlier than mono, which is true in India right now. And India is very averse to adopting new technology very fast. It's always in a copycat mode. So whatever happens in the West, it happens here 2 years later.
Yeah, 2 or 5 years later, precisely. So what is the acceptability of the your structures in India?
So India, we have primarily being a company based in Pune, we have done about 500 megawatts in India, which could have been 5 gigawatts had we been in US. So it has been slow as compared to other tracker companies globally, but very fast compared to a Indian tracker company. So it has been pretty good for us, but it could have been better had the public been more accepting technology. Faster.
So what is your experience about this 500 megawatt in India? The customer calls for any fault or any detection for the faults or anything which is you came across?
So thankfully, we have a 99.995% uptime in trackers. We have supplied trackers to most of the large IPPs like Renew, Mahindra, Hero Future, Adani, and Mahindra, and everybody. And we have got repeat orders from companies like Tata Power and others. So India, we are customers are all very happy. They have got the gains which they're supposed to get, which is anything between 16 to 17% in North India or maybe 18 to 20% in South India. In Maharashtra, the gains have been at around 18%. And the latest bifacial plant, the gains showed over a nearby fixed tilt plant is around 26%. So gains have been proven by recorded data over 5 years.
So there is a gain of 18%.
Yeah.
So what is the differential cost we need to pay for that?
So typically a well-designed fixed tilt plant, let's say in Maharashtra kind of wind zone, it should be a 32 to 35 ton design. And considering the cost for fixed tilt and trackers, the cost differential should not be more than 35 lakhs to 40 lakhs between a fixed tilt and a tracker.
It's per megawatt, right?
Per megawatt basis.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
So, Shailesh ji, here I have a question actually. So, Prasoon this side. So we know that out of the total portfolio, the tracker market is hardly like 3-4% as on date in India. And there also, like, there are a lot of Chinese players which are very much active. So we, as an Indian manufacturer, we as Pennar also tried to develop. We developed our tracker in the year 2010.
Yeah.
But the kind of pricing, so steel prices are very volatile in India, but same is not the case with the Chinese companies. So where there is a very small market, And in that particular market, you being an Indian tracker manufacturer and others being like Chinese players which are active in the market, how you are able to sustain where the market is very less, where steel prices are very much volatile in India, and thirdly, you have a lot of competitors with good pricing from right. outside.
So normally the type of customers we go to, for example, we did a project for Amity or for lab cables or in the private space or for rooftop space or whatever, the people look for bankability. Now Chinese, there's only one tracker who is bankable and he's not very active in India right now. Otherwise there are of course Chinese companies, but none of them are bankable. So competition I'm not worried about from China. Our main competition is from American or European tracker companies. Price-wise, we are competitive, but technology-wise, we are much better than those. So when presented properly to a customer on the technology differences between us and maybe a US-based tracker company, we generally win. There's no problem there. Chinese, we are not worried about because there's no bankability with the Chinese tracker companies. Okay.
Thank you.
So let's...
Yeah, sure.
Since it's 500 megawatt, what you have installed in India, I'm assuming the predominantly the factor. Yeah, it's audible now. So predominantly we are looking at ground mount systems. So since you know we, at Havells we are at.
You speak little loud.
So at Havells we are more you know concentrated on rooftop. So my question is. Respect to rooftop, what is the for the rooftop projects, number one. And number two, what kind of challenges you have faced in rooftop, because roof, putting on a ground, putting on a ground and putting on a roof, there is a huge difference. So, if...
So you're right, the rooftop tracker is a totally different product than a ground mount. You can't use the ground mount design on the rooftop because of various challenges like you can't do foundation on a roof, etc. So we have just recently developed a very different rooftop tracker model, and we have just finalized a first 100 kilowatt order in Hyderabad on a college for a rooftop. Now one of the requirements while doing a rooftop tracker is that the roof has to be RCC. So that eliminates a large chunk of the rooftop market with industrial sheds and things like that. You can't use a tracker there. But having said that, a rooftop tracker where RCC is available makes a lot of sense with bifacial modules, because the metric in a rooftop technology selection is maximum generation per meter square. And in which case, the bifacial modules with trackers, nothing can beat. So as long as you have a roof which is properly oriented east-west, there are no obstructions of shadow in terms of trees or towers or whatever. And it's a RCC roof. So a lot of conditions to be met. But if those are met, then there's nothing which beats a tracker with a bifacial.
Yeah, thank you so much. So let's quickly move on the inverter side. So if you can just brief about the technological advancement innovations in the inverters and what is coming next.
As we all know that inverter is the heart of the solar plant. So that's a very critical component in the entire system. So when we are selecting up one particular inverter, so there are a lot of questions are already there in the mind and how those things are going to help in terms of better yield generation, operation and maintenance activity. So these are the main major question which always comes in your mind. As we have seen, the solar in India is already now is almost a decade old. So it has started long back in 2008-09 and where the plant size were pretty small and the inverter capacities are also pretty small, like 500 kilowatt central inverter, 1 megawatt central inverter. But as the technology advancement has come up day by day and even the technology in terms of PV module has also increased. So the system demand size and the volume, like the project which was initially was just 5 megawatt was the biggest plant, but now we are talking about 100 and 200 megawatt a plant. So then in terms of that, we need to look at the plant design perspectively, how it should be able to do it in a smarter way, plus generation guarantee, sure. Operation maintenance, ease of operation and maintenance. So the inverter has developed their advancement has happened in inverter in all the phases. Like central inverters, now we have seen that it has reached to a capacity of 5 megawatt, whereas five years down the line, or maybe even back, we see the inverter was only 1 megawatt capacity. So that is the development has happened, because the component which are used in that inverter has also now has increased, and they have also got a reliable components, and the design and technology has been and the engineering has done by the people who are designing the system. Similarly, for string inverter also, we have seen previously 10 kilowatt or 20 kilowatt was the biggest size of inverter in string inverter, and when we are talking about rooftop plant, so we have to use multiple solar inverters to make 100 kilowatt or 200 kilowatt of plant. But now we have seen that solar inverter, which is like 100 kilowatt of capacity, is available. So single inverter can also able to use it in a single plant to just to have less number of component. That means you are less number of troubles you will be seeing in the system. So how it is possible that the component, the principle of inverter is still remain same, that it's still using the same technology, DC to AC conversion is happening. But to make it happen more efficiently, the efficiency has been key for the inverter always, that how best efficiency it is achieved from DC to AC, and that is what we are able to get the money. The money is actually coming out from the generation, which is coming out from the inverter. So the component selection, the component advancement has happened. The IGBT is now available in 1500 volt. Previously, it was not available. There were only few limited manufacturer or few limited component supplier who was able to supply 1500 volt IGBTs. But now, the advancement of technology or in components happens so high, so that multiple players have opted for that technology. And see, we have seen that products are already there on the ground. Like most of the inverter manufacturers, you name them and you'll find each and every inverter would have the inverter in their portfolio of 1500 volt DC, which can be harnessed easily. So this is only possible because the technology advancement has happened in not only in on the inverter side, it also happened on the component level. So that's made us make more in terms of designing and making it more efficient. Plus, inverter, as we said, it's a major part of the solar plant. So it also need to be very, very smart. So here to understand that PV modules just give electricity, we know that. But the measurement of that PV module is only happen inside the inverter. We come to know only how much amount of PV power is being captured from the solar, from the sun, and what is the amount of power is getting generated. What is the string level current has been measured at the DC side. So this has happened because the inverter technology has evolved, and the features has been added, so that this gives an ease of to decide whether your plant is in a proper function or not. And that's what inverters are now coming up with, a more advanced technology, artificial intelligences. People are talking about that, how we can predict the fault level if it is going to come in near future. There would be some internal data bank which inverter will going to be storing all the time, and based on that it will give the prediction that this is what it is going to be the scenario. And so that's what I would like to address here. So basically the thing is, like, now the inverter becomes smarter, intelligent, safe to operate, so that people can consider in a smaller plant or bigger plant or a ground mounted plant, wherever it is need to be considered. So it's not only just a question that only specific company or specific people should be doing the job, but here it's now the thing is, like, the inverter has become so robust and safe to operate. So that's what technology advancement has happened inside the in the machine. So that's what I want to bring it across. Anything, I think other players, other,
yeah, I have a question before that. So since you are developing new and new technologies and transformation in layman's language from 1000 volts to 1500 volts and all, so what kind of support you need from the other component suppliers, not inside the inverter, but for the system?
Basically, PV module is the one of the major component and the inverters. So altogether, when PV modules are capable of to make harness 1500 volt, the other thing is that the cables which we are using, the safety point, the safety thing, the connectors, the connecting cables, and the best installation practice. These are the major thing we need to take in our consideration when we are designing for a 1500 volt system. So these are the challenges which I have seen.
I hope you must be offering the trainings to the EPC.
Yes, we do a skill development thing for ground level people as well as for the EPC companies and some certified program for installers. So by that we can able to educate them. We show them the right installation practice. What are the connections they need to check before doing any installation, either it is PV module or it is an inverter. So when it is coming to a complete system, when it is completely connected, it's safe. But if it is still having some open connection, it remains very risky for the people who are handling the things.